Hello. In this video, we will see some basics about plasma half-life. First, we will understand what is plasma half-life. Then we will see distribution and elimination half-life. And finally, we will understand half-life for first order and zero order kinetic. Let's get started. First, what is plasma half-life? Plasma half-life is time taken for drug concentration to fall to half of its initial value. For example, let's say initial concentration of drug is 30 mg per liter. Now due to its elimination, its concentration gradually decreases. Here, time required for it to reach 15 mg per liter, which is half of 30 mg per liter, is plasma half-life. That was very easy. Now let's understand difference between distribution half-life and elimination half-life. Okay, so this is blood, where we measure concentration of drug. We know that blood is connected with all the tissues in the body. As an example, I have shown brain, liver, kidney and muscles. Now let's say we have given a drug to the patient. Initially, this produces high concentration in blood. But soon it enters in other tissues also. Due to this distribution, there is rapid fall in plasma concentration of drug. This happens till the equilibrium is achieved. Half-life during this period is called distribution half-life. Now the liver or kidney or whichever route is involved starts to eliminate drug. Due to this, now there is gradual fall in plasma concentration. Plasma half-life for this elimination is called elimination half-life. If we make a graph of log plasma concentration against time, it looks like this. Here, this initial rapid fall is due to distribution and this gradual fall is due to elimination. Both half-lives can be calculated from respective slopes. Among the two, elimination half-life is more important, and usually when we say half-life, it's elimination half-life that we mean. On that note, let's understand half-life for first order and zero order elimination. Starting with first order elimination. In this graph, we have time on x-axis and plasma concentration on y-axis. In first order kinetic, rate of elimination is directly proportional to plasma concentration. As we can see, at higher concentration, the level of drug is falling faster. And at lower concentrations, it is slow. Because of this, plasma half-life remains constant in first order kinetic. To confirm this, let's measure half-lives for these two different concentrations. For this point, half concentration is this much. Time required for this 50% fall in concentration is this long. Now for this point, half concentration is this much. And time required for this fall is this long. As you can clearly see, the time required in both the cases is equal. Thus we can say plasma half-life is constant in first order elimination kinetic. Now let's come to zero order kinetic. Here rate of elimination is constant irrespective of plasma concentration. Because of that, plasma half-life varies at different concentrations. Or in other words, it's not constant. Let's confirm. See, for this point, half concentration is this much. Time required here is this long. And for this point, half concentration is this much. And time required for this fall is this long. As you can see, it's not same. If you measure half-life from different points, you will get different results. Thus we can say plasma half-life is not constant in zero order elimination kinetic. This covers all the points for this video. Quick summary. Half-life is time required for plasma concentration to fall by 50% of its earlier value. Two different half-lives, distribution half-life and elimination half-life, are seen after giving a drug. In first order kinetic, half-life is constant, and in zero order kinetic, half-life is not constant. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.